Here we are in Kali Linux. Let's take a look at external C2. I'm going to create a listener, Cobalt Strike listeners. Press add. And we will call this external C2 TCP. And we will select external C2 as our payload type. Port 2222 is okay with me. We now have an external C2 server running on our malware c2.losenolove.com team server. Now, what are we going to use as an external C2? Well, let's go to the Cobalt Strike website, click support, and go down to external C2. This is the documentation on external C2. I do link to a few third-party projects you can look at if you want to get an idea of the different frameworks or even ready-to-use tools available to play around with external C2. But for this demo, we're going to use the example inside of the Cobalt Strike external C2 specification. And that example is a simple C program that runs on the target, connects to the external C2 server directly, requests the payload, and relays frames back and forth. That's it. So the program is actually here in the external C2 specification. And I actually built it already. I had to copy and paste this program out of the PDF file. And I built it with the new compiler toolchain Windows cross-compilation toolkit. So the minimal new for Windows 32. If you just run build.sh here, that'll build it. That's what it looks like. Okay. Now let's go ahead and run the external C2 combination client and server, this external program. So here we have Cobalt Strike. Our external C2 server is on port 2222. Here I am on my Windows 10 target, and I have my previously compiled external C2 over here. And we're just going to run that. And our example does tell us what its arguments are, which is host and port. And I want to say the example requires us to use an IP directly, so I'm going to just look up malwarec2.losenolove.com and do 54.80.166.26, port 2222. Oops. Ah. Not 266.26. And there we go. Our external C2 client is now running and connecting, in this case, directly to the external C2 server. Here we are back in Kali Linux, and you can see that I have a session associated with my external C2 TCP listener, and it's user Jim Stevens running inside of example.exe, which is a 32-bit program, PID 4656. So that's an example of using an external C2.